And this is Aparna Rajkumar, the voice of 3BL, handing you over to the official presenter of 3BL, Rishi Raj, the host with the most.
Very good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome once again
to
3BL season number 2. This is round 3 and we are here at lovely Professional University in Jalandhar. On behalf of the whole crew and the 3BL team, I would welcome all of you present here and all the viewers who will be watching us live and who have already joined us on Facebook and YouTube. Many thanks to you too. Let me remind you, today is Conference A, which means that this is the men's league of season 2, and it's going to be as aggressive and as interesting as it has always been so far. I would like to thank all our sponsors, ladies and gentlemen. I would appreciate if all of you give a big round of applause to all the sponsors while I say that out, because without their support, this wouldn't have been possible. Starting with our venue partners, who has allowed us to be here for 3 rounds and 3 weekends, and we've loved it the most. So the lovely venue partners, thank you so much. Lovely Professional University. Our exclusive radio partner, Red FM 93.5. Hydration partner, Kelby Packaged Drinking Water. Our energy partners, Red Bull. Official hoop partner, Rido. Official merchandise partner, which is the jerseys that you see on referees and the players. My Sports Factory, the merchandise partner. And our nutrition partner, Proathletics. Thank you so much for believing in us and joining us as a part of 3BL. Can I have a round of applause for all our sponsors, please? Thank you, guys. Now, ladies and gentlemen, today is Conference A, and you know what Conference A means, that this is the first 6 teams of the Men's League of 3BL Season 2 will be playing today. You know that they have given us amazing matches and very close matches. Conference A and Conference B both. Can't wait to start the day. Today will be the Conference A Round 3. So let's bring out the first 2 teams playing game number 1 for Conference A of 3BL Season 2 Men's League. Put your hands together and please welcome Team Chandigarh Challengers. You know about Chandigarh Challengers. They have a jersey number 7, Dhruv Burman, who was the MVP from last round. They are also the defending champions. Now, in against the defending champions from round 2, Chandigarh Challengers. Please put your hands together and welcome. They call it the home team because they have a homeboy playing in this team who's from LPU. Put your hands together and please welcome Team Aizawl Legends. Players to look out for in this team. Jersey number 7 from Chandigarh Challengers and jersey number 4 from Aizawl Legends. So yes, everybody, let's bring out the referees for game number 1 of Conference A. Hello. Everybody, please stick around for a photo op. Thank you, guys. Thank you. Can I now invite the captains of Chandigarh Challengers and Aizawl Legends for the toss? Chandigarh Challengers and the MVP has called for black for the first game. Gold it is. Chandigarh Challengers have lost the toss. Aizawl gets the ball. Thank you. Back to you, Aparna.
Thank you, Rishi. An exciting game on the cards. Chandigarh Challengers have already won 2 rounds. And they won the first round and the second round, for which the first round was Amjot Singh Gill, who was the MVP. And we have Dhruv Sushil Burman, who was the MVP for the last round. And now they're going to be playing against Aizawl Legends. Here we have the Chandigarh Challengers team. Himanshu Jangra wearing jersey number 9. And Ravi Kumar, jersey number 5. Narendra Ratti, jersey number 8. And Dhruv Burman wearing jersey number 7. They are wearing the yellow jerseys, as you can see. And here we have the Aizawl Legends. Ashpreet Bular, homeboy, wearing jersey number 4. Yudrik Pereira, jersey number 5. Basil Philip, jersey number 6. And Rajat KR, jersey number 7. They did have a fairly decent round 2. And they will be hoping to improve on their performance from round 2. So we can expect much improved performance, considering that Chandigarh Challengers are without the services of the Sultan of Swat, Amjot Singh Gill. So we do have a few big names missing in this round, and that might just work things out and level the playing field among all the six teams that are in fray today for Conference A. So it is going to be up to Dhruv Sushil Burman to get his team going without Amjot. And he is pretty much a natural leader on the floor. He's going to be the alpha in his team. So it's going to be interesting to see how he gets his team together and whether they can retain the title that they won in round one and two. Going up against Arshpreet Bular and co. They have Udrik Pereira as well over there, the big man. And Udrik is going to be bested by Ravi Kumar. And that is Basil Phillips starting off and almost making it no. He's fouled in the process. That was an early foul that's been called. Extremely early, in fact, just 6 seconds into the game. It's a 10-minute game, folks. In the 10 minutes, whichever team scores 21 first or whoever has the highest points in the regulation time wins. And the rules are pretty much different. That's Basil Phillips opening scores for Aizawl Legends. Dropping it inside to Dhruv. Picked up by Ravi Kumar. Ravi Kumar is not able to make it because Udrik Pereira had a piece of that ball. Basil Phillips outside the arc. Spotting up for a two. Basil opens up with another two for them. So that's three quick points. Dhruv tries to get one back in return, but not yet into the groove. Ravi Kumar taking it all the way to the hoop. Basil is there to pick up the rebound. He crashed the boards. That's Arsh Pular. Turn round to Udrik Pereira with a jump shot there. He's not able to make it. Ravi Kumar outside. To Narendra Ratti. Dhruv. Well stolen by Basil Phillips, but that is going to be a shot clock violation, and it is anyway going to be Aizawl ball. Udrik Pereira goes out, and in comes Rajat. An early change. Aizawl ball. A much level playing field without the presence of Amjot Singh Gill here. Rajat spotting up for a two from behind the arc. Not able to make it. Basil Phillips has the rebound. Arshpreet drops it inside to Rajat. What a beautiful assist there. Almost unchallenged. That was Rajat for Aizawl. They have a quick 4-point lead. Chandigarh yet to start scoring. Narendra Ratti all the way to the basket despite the challenge posed by Basil. Makes that one an open scores for Chandigarh Challengers. Dhruv, ball saved. Back to Ravi Kumar. Narendra tries to split the defense there, almost losing it. Great defensive efforts there. But that is a shot clock violation, folks. So you have to be aware that it is unlike the 5x5 where you have 24 seconds to complete your shot. You have just half of that, 12 seconds. So you have to remap your brain to start thinking the 3BL way or the 3x3 way, rather. Udrik Pereira taking it all the way to the hoop and fouled by Ravi Kumar. And just to remind you once more, it's not the individual fouls that matter, but it's going to be the team fouls that matter. So the more fouls, 7, 8 and 9 onwards, you have 2 free throws each. So that's something that you do not want to do or get yourselves in. Udrik Pereira spotting up from behind the arc once more off the rebound of his free throw. Dhruv Barman from outside. Rajat KR pulls down that rebound back to Udrik. Udrik to Arshpreet Bular. Making a floater there, but he's missing it. Dhruv yet to find his groove. That's a foul called on Bular for pushing Dhruv. 7:53 in the game. And Chandigarh Challengers trail by 3 points. Narendra Ratti drops it out to Ravi Kumar. Takes a jumper, but not making it. Arshpreet Bular with the rebound. dropping it inside to Udrik. Udrik barreling his way inside off the glass despite the foul and the challenge. He makes it. It's an and one situation. He will go to the free throw line for this. Missing that one, and the ball is now with Chandigarh Challengers. That is Himanshu Jangra taking that attempt. Dhruv back to Himanshu. Himanshu fouled by Rajat. It is going to be Chandigarh ball. 4 points down with 7:30 on the clock. Dhruv drops it inside, but there is no one to pick it up. So it is going to be a turnover. A tad frustrated there because Ravi Kumar did not anticipate that drop pass there. Udrik going all the way to the basket with a turnaround. And he makes it. Does he make? No, he misses it. Dhruv is there to pull down that rebound. Jangra spotting up for a two from behind the arc. Rebounded by Rajat. Rajat back to Bular. Bular tries to go inside. Kicks it out to Rajat. Off the glass, and he makes it. A very, very sweet left-handed hook there. Dhruv Barman spots up for a two. Rebounded by Arshpreet. Back to Udrik. Bular spots up for a two. And it's nothing but net for Bular. It's an 8 points for Aizawl, while Chandigarh have just won. Definitely not feeling it today, Chandigarh. Jangra picks up the rebound and tries to make it. Rebound pulled down by Bular. Out to Udrik. Udrik spotting up for a two from behind the arc. Rebounded by Dhruv. Jangra dropping it behind his back to Dhruv. And that's beats for you. Dhruvy groovy. He's found his groove. Udrik. A very nice move there, very sensible, despite having Ravi Kumar over there. That's 9 points to Aizawl, and Chandigarh Challengers have just 6 minutes and 12 on the clock. This is the first timeout that they've taken, and already Chandigarh Challengers have 3 fouls while Aizawl have 2. Which of these teams is going to be pushed towards the 7th foul remains to be seen, but whoever is going there to get that position first, that 7-foul position, the other one's going to take advantage of that. So they're going to have to watch out for that. And with a big fellow like Udrik inside, Ravi Kumar is going to have to be a tad wary about having him under the boards there, because Udrik does have the footwork and the ability and agility to do a lot of damage, pulling down those rebounds or making those shots. So Udrik is someone that you want to keep outside of his comfort zone as early as possible. And Bular is someone that can turn on the heat as well. Once he feels it going, then that's when he's going to start taking advantage. But one can't write Dhruv Barman off. This guy can step it on and turn it on anytime. And it's going to be very exciting when he does that. Jangra with the jumper. A very nice, sweet, floating jumper there. Makes it. Rebound pulled down by Bular. Rajat. Splitting the defense, takes it inside, but Dhruv rejects it, but a foul has been called in the process. That's the 4th foul for Challengers. This is something they have to watch out for. Rajat at the free throw line. Missing that one, rebounded by Jangra. Out to Barman. Beats takes it inside. Nice pin move there, but he's not able to make it. He's not able to finish it. Basil Philip pulls down the rebound. Bular spotting up from two. Rebounded by Himanshu Jangra. Tries a shot there, but that's not good. Dhruv spots up for a two from behind the arc. Missing that one. Jangra pulls down the rebound, and off the glass he makes it. It's 1 point for Jangra there, adding to the Chandigarh Challengers score. So the score is now 5, while Aizawl have 9. And all of a sudden, it seems like Chandigarh Challengers are actually stepping back and finding their groove some more. Getting those points up. There's been a lull in the scoring for Aizawl for a bit now. Basil Philip fouled in the process. That is Narendra Ratti picking up that foul. So that's foul number five. Halfway, almost halfway mark. And then we find Chandigarh challengers already have five fouls. Basil Philip makes that one. 10 points for Aizawl, and it's a 5-point difference. Dhruv Burman spotting up for a two from behind the arc. Doesn't make it. Udrik is there to pull down the rebound. Bular from outside. Going to take it inside. A Euro step there, but that was challenge. Despite that, the shot will count. It's an and one situation. The sixth foul. There you go, folks. It's going to get quite unpleasant for Chandigarh challengers at the rate the fouls are being committed. Makes that one. That's 12 points for Aizawl already. Basil Philip with the ball. Bular spotting up for a two from outside. Udrik Pereira is there to aid it and get it back in his team's hands. But it is now Chandigarh ball. That's Dhruv Burman. Rebound pulled down by Bular once more. Drops it to Udrik. Udrik, a cross pass there to Basil Philip at the arc. Narendra Ratti pulling it down. Beats. And that's another two. Shredding it there is Dhruv beats Burman. Chandigarh challengers with 7 points now. And off the glass, a very, very sweet touch there by Bular. Ball saved by Basil. Once more, Bular will take it up to the hoop and kicks it out to Basil, who's waiting. That's Dhruv spotting up for another two from behind the arc. It's a tad short. He will take it inside. Finding Ratti. Spotting up, that's Burman with another two. That's his third two in the game. Nothing but net. Beats is feeling it now. Arsh Bular kicks it out to Udrik Pereira, who's outside. Takes it all the way to the hoop with a sweet finger roll. That's Udrik Pereira. And in return, Narendra Ratti does them a favor by taking 2 points on that attempt. Basil Philip, ball intercepted by Dhruv. And beautiful SS, no-look pass behind. Unfortunately, Dhruv did not clear the arc. That's what the referee calls. But that was a sweet, sweet assist. If only Dhruv had cleared that one. There's a beautiful no-look assist there to his waiting Narendra Ratti. So the shot won't count. But here you can see that they're back in the game and it's just a 3-point ball game. 3 minutes 15 remain on the clock. But Chandigarh challengers have 6 fouls. Aizawl have just 2. It's interesting that Dhruv already has 6 points out of this 11. And they all came from behind the arc. The lack of the big man for them, Amjot Singh Gill, is hurting them inside the paint. But Ravi Kumar is fairly busy trying to keep Udrik Pereira outside of his comfort zone. But that doesn't seem to work because Pereira is really mixing it up by moving in and out, playing offense and defense. So it's a tough job there. And now Beats has taken it upon himself to stop the big man. While Ravi Kumar takes a breather. That's Basil Philip beating his man, take it all the way to the glass and lays it in. Narendra Ratti back to Beats. Challenged by Pereira over there. Ball saved by Jangra and Beats will have it. Drops it back to Jangra. Jangra behind the arc for a two. Nope, doesn't go in. That's Basil Philip legalizing it by taking it outside. But Rajat is back in action for their team. Ball stolen. Rather, the ball has been lost. Jangra for a two from outside and he makes it. So it's a 2-point ball game. Basil Philip. Udrik picks it up, although it was an air ball and was fouled in the process by Beats. Dhruv Burman a tad unhappy with those calls. There you can see the 7th foul has been committed. So every foul henceforth is going to be 2-2 free throws. And Pereira has to make sure that he uses those free throws to good effect and put up those points on the board. That's one for him, one of two. It's very important that each of these teams pick up that victory in the first game itself. So the pressure to win the second game is less so they can go into the semi-finals. And Udrik Pereira ices both. So he's has 17 on the board right now for his team. The shot was bested by Rajat. Unfortunately, a foul has been called. So Jangra is going to the free throw line with two throws, and it's an opportunity for him to close the difference. Yurik Pereira not very happy, and Bullard wants to challenge it. But that's Jangra is going to the free throw. Makes that one. And that's a second free throw opportunity for Jangra. Can he make this? He doesn't. But the ball is still with the Chandigarh challengers. And Dhruv beats Barman, forces a shot there. It's an air ball, but pulled down by Rajat. Bullard with the ball. Hustling defense there by Chandigarh challengers. Ball stolen by Rati. Jangra back to Barman. Jangra spots up for a two from behind the arc. Dhruv is there with the ball, back out to Rati. Rati behind the arc. Great defensive efforts there and offensive rebounds as well for Chandigarh challengers. Rajat spots up for a two from behind the arc. Bullard with the rebound, but he's been fouled by Narendra Rati. Some words exchanged. No harm done. A minute and 38 to go, and 3 points is what separates Aizawl and Chandigarh, with Chandigarh trailing. Ashpreet Bullard on the free throw line. Not a friendly ring. Goes inside and comes out. He's going to have to make this one. This is foul number 8. Makes the second one. So it's 18-14 now. All they need is 3 points to close this game. Or play it all the way to regulation time. Oh, what a finish there. A forced one by Rati, but he makes it count. It matters. Off the glass. And Jangra, that was a hard foul with a barreling Ashpreet Bullard, who was trying to split the defense and go to the hoop. So Bullard will have 2 free throws. That's foul number 9. Makes it. That's 19 points for them. All they need is 21. Minute and 22 remaining. Bullard makes the second one as well. Rati from outside. Rebound pulled down by Basil Philip. Back to Bullard. Nice pass there to a cutting Rajat, who makes it off the glass. And that is 21, folks. Aizawl legends have beaten Chandigarh challengers in this league phase. Chandigarh challengers are definitely going to take this loss very hard. And with a minute and 4 to go, they have iced this game. Great effort by Aizawl. Definitely missing the services of Amjot Singh Gill. Aizawl did have the going a tad easier. Yudrik did have a fairly easy run inside the paint as well. Ravi Kumar was unable to contain Yudrik, but was good all-round effort there by Aizawl legends. They are definitely looking comfortable in this win. But knowing how aggressive and how motivated the Chandigarh challengers are, it will be interesting to see how they make a comeback in the second game and see if they can make it to the semi-finals. So it was 21-15 in favor of Aizawl. So the next game will be played between Goa Snipers and Bangalore Machars. Now let's go over to Rishi, who has Ashpreet Bullard and Rajat on the floor with him.
That was game number 1 from Conference A of round 3 of season 2. And I have 2 players from the winning team, which is Aizawl Legends. They beat the defending champion in the opening game. I have Ashpreet Bullard, who is the local boy from LPU, and Rajat, his teammate. Ashpreet, I'm going to ask you, पहले तो कैसा लग रहा है दैट पहली ही गेम में कॉन्फ्रेंस ए में डिफेंडिंग चैंपियंस को आपने बीट कर दिया है?
काफी अच्छा लग रहा है. इट्स अ डिफरेंट फीलिंग. लाइक लास्ट राउंड में हमारी टीम कुछ ज्यादा अच्छा परफॉर्म नहीं कर पाई, But this time we've come stronger and dekho, bahut acha laga pehla match jeet ke.
Yes, your sync was great. You were on fire today on the court, Rajat. Kya kha ke aaye the yaar aap?
Didn't eat anything special, kuch khaya special nahi hai. But we've got a good set roster now, very well balanced. We play unselfish, we shared the ball a lot, so that really clicked.
What do you think that your team strength was compared to the last round in this opening game?
So this time we kind of exploited their weakness. They didn't have size inside, so they kind of pushed the ball down. But then again, they got up really close. I mean, Dhruv did what he does, he shoots. So yeah, that we kind of slacked off there, but we came back really well. We had the big guy, he did his job inside and was kind of sorted from there.
आपको क्या लगता है that was a presence of a player like Amjot in that team missing? Is that what your advantage was also?
Obviously yes, it is an advantage. But अगर Amjot भी होता तब भी हम अपना पूरा 100% देते क्योंकि last round में हम कुछ अच्छा नहीं खेल पाए and we have our height in this round. So yeah, we'll give in our 100%.
Awesome, great game. All the best for the rest one. Thank you so much for talking with me. That was Rajat and Arshpreet Bhullar. Let's see, this is changing. Let's see what happens next. Back to you, Aparna.